Oh boy, the Easter Bunny left me a basket earlier. Let's see what's inside. Whole carrots and powdered sugar? I might have an idea what to do with this. Hello everyone and welcome to an Easter episode of Cooking Corner with me, Giuseppe CrimiVaroli. Today for you, we're going to be making a cream cheese frosting covered carrot cake. Now this is a two-pronged recipe. You've got one prong being your carrot cake and the other prong being your cream cheese frosting. So the ingredients for your carrot cake are as follows. You're going to need some flour. You're going to need baking soda and baking powder. You're going to need a stick of butter. You're going to need cinnamon and vanilla. You're going to need vegetable oil. You're gonna need ground nutmeg. You're gonna need brown sugar and white sugar. You're gonna need some eggs. And you're gonna need some carrots. All right, now for your cream cheese frosting, you're gonna need the following. You're gonna need powdered sugar and a lot of it. You're gonna need vanilla. You're gonna need 2 sticks of butter. And you're gonna need 2 bars of cream cheese. It's 16 ounces in total. Very importantly, you need your cream cheese to be soft by the time you make your frosting. So take it out of the fridge long before you start cooking your carrot cake. Now for the hardware. In terms of hardware, you're going to need the following. You're going to need something to shred your carrots. I'm using a cheese grater. You're going to need something to peel your carrots. I'm using a vegetable peeler. You're going to need various measuring spoons and various measuring cups. You're going to need a knife to cut the ends off your carrots. You're going to need 2 8- or 9-inch round cake pans. You're going to need an electric mixer or a large wooden spoon to mix your batter together. You're going to need at least 1 large mixing bowl. You're going to need cooking spray to grease your pan. And you're gonna need scissors and parchment paper to line your pan. Step number one, as always, folks, is gonna be wash your hands. Go ahead, turn your water on, stick your mitts underneath and get them nice and moist. Once your hands are nice and wet, go ahead and put some soap on them. 2 squirts is my preference. Then, rub that soap all around your hands. Get on the back of the knuckles, get them between the fingers. Once your hands are nice and soapy, stick them back under the water and wash that soap off. Once you're convinced your hands are clean, go ahead, put your fingers out, turn the water off, shake your hands dry, and we're ready to cook. On to step number two. And step number two is going to be peel, cut, and shred your carrots. So, you're going to need 3 cups of shredded carrots. So just peel your carrots and then use your grater to shred them until you've got 3 cups. So go ahead and cut the ends off your carrots, like this. Then you're going to want to peel your carrots, like this. Once your carrot has been cut and peeled, you can then begin to shred it. So just take your carrot, put it against your grater, and start shredding it. And then do that for all your carrots until you have 3 cups. Well, it took a little while and we made a bit of a mess, but we've got 3 cups of shredded carrots. Just for reference, we used about 7 medium to large carrots. Now that our carrots are all shredded, it's time to move on to step number three. And step number three is going to be combine your dry ingredients in a large mixing bowl. Now, into your bowl goes 2.5 cups of flour. 1, 2.5. Next, you're gonna add 1 cup each of brown sugar and white sugar. The brown sugar has to be packed tight in the measuring cup. So, 1 cup of packed brown sugar. Now, a cup of sugar. Next, you'll add 2 teaspoons of brown cinnamon. 1, 2. Now you're gonna need 1.5 teaspoons of baking soda. 1 teaspoon of baking powder. And finally, 1/2 teaspoon of ground nutmeg. Now that all your dry ingredients are in your bowl, just mix them together. Make sure to break up all the clumps of brown sugar in your batter. Now that our dry ingredients are all mixed up, it's time to move on to the next step. And the next step in question is going to be incrementally add your wet ingredients. Now, since you're going to start adding your wet ingredients, it's time to switch from a whisk or a fork to your electric beaters. Now you're going to add 1 stick of butter melted, 1 cup of vegetable oil. Then take your beaters and mix that up. Your eggs 1 at a time to the batter, you're going to add 1 tablespoon of vanilla. Then beat it together. Mostly complete, you can preheat your oven to 350 degrees. Now that you've preheated your oven, you can add your final dry ingredient, which is going to be your carrots. So go ahead and add your 3 cups of carrots into your batter and beat it all together. Once you're done, your batter should look like this. Moving on to step number 5. And step number 5 is going to be prepare your pans. Now, you've got your 2 8- or 9-inch circular pans. How do you prepare them? Don't worry, I'm going to tell you. So, you're going to want a pair of scissors, a pencil, and your parchment paper. Pull out your parchment paper until it is larger than one of your pans. Then put it down on the counter. put your pan down on top of your parchment paper and trace the pan on the parchment paper. Now you've got a circle on your parchment paper. Rip another piece of parchment paper that is larger than the circle, but smaller than the sheet you have now. Now you have two pieces of parchment paper and one circle that is the size of your pans. What you're going to do is take your scissors and cut out that circle on both pieces of parchment paper. Do that now. Now that you've got your circles cut out, you can discard your excess parchment paper. Now, take your parchment paper circles and put them inside your pans. Now, you may notice that your parchment paper does not fit perfectly inside your pans. This is to be expected, and you can use your scissors to trim off any excess. Now that you've got your circles in the bottom of your pan, you're going to grab your cooking spray and spray the parchment paper and the sides of your pans. You want to make sure that cake does not stick inside the pan. Now that your pans have been sprayed, grab yourself a rubber spatula and evenly distribute your batter between your two pans. Now that your batter is evenly distributed between your two pans, use your rubber spatula or spoon or whatever you're using to flatten it out on the top. Now that your carrot cakes are in your pan and evenly distributed, you can stick them in your oven for 40 minutes, but we're gonna check them at 35. So it's been 35 minutes and we just checked our cakes and they look like they're done a little bit early. So we're gonna take them out and let them sit in the pans on the counter. Now, this is one of those instances where the toothpick test will not avail you because of the moist nature of a carrot cake. All right, these cakes are looking perfect, but we're gonna have to let them sit in the pan for 10 minutes before we run a knife along the outside and pop them out of the pan to transfer them to a cooling rack. So it's been 10 minutes and our cakes have cooled down considerably. What we're gonna do now is take this knife and run it along the outside of the cake and then pop the cake out and put it somewhere to cool. I've got a cooling rack. So go ahead, take your knife, stick it along the edge, and run it around your cake. You should meet with little resistance. Once you've gone all the way around, you can take your cake, pop it into your hand, peel off that skin, and put it on the rack to cool. Now, I'm going back and saying this again because it's so important. You need to leave your 2 sticks of butter and 2 bars of cream cheese out to soften the entire time you're making your carrot cake. These need to be softened. If they're not, you'll ruin the whole recipe. Now that our cakes are cooling, it's time to move on to the next step, which is gonna be make your cream cheese frosting. Now, for your cream cheese frosting, what you're gonna need to do is add your 2 bricks of softened cream cheese. And your 2 sticks of softened butter. I mean, why would I buy half sticks? Now that your butter and cream cheese are in the bowl, use your mixer and beat them until they're creamy. keep beating it until there are no clumps left. It should look like this. Once your butter and cream cheese are appropriately blended together, you can add 2 teaspoons of vanilla to the mix. Go ahead and add those now. Once your vanilla is in, you're gonna slowly add 8, that's right, you heard me correctly, 8 cups of powdered sugar. Now you're gonna take it and pour it in a little bit at a time and then mix together with your beans. Now that our frosting is done, let's go for a little taste test. That's good. Very sweet. Delicious, though. It's gonna be a great cake. So, your cakes are done and your frosting is done, but your cakes aren't cool yet. I am not exaggerating when I say this. You have to wait for your cakes to be completely cool before putting the frosting on. Otherwise, the frosting will slide right off the cake. So, wait until your cakes are completely cool to continue with this recipe. Time for the next step, and that's gonna be plating. Now, I know what you're thinking. Giuseppe, don't you always do plating at the end? I do, but things get a lot more complicated when you've got a cake. What you're gonna need to do is look at your 2 cakes and decide which one you wanna cut the top off of. And then you gotta grab your largest knife, preferably a serrated one, and slice the top off of that cake, and then put it on your cake platter. Now you may be asking yourself, which cake do I cut the top off of? Well, don't worry, I'm gonna tell you how I do it. Looking at the 2 cakes, this one has sunken in more in the middle. That means this one has a better dome to the top. So this will be my top cake, and I'll cut the top off of this cake. Now that we've decapitated our bottom cake, it's time to put that on the tray and start assembling. Go ahead, take your bottom cake and drop it right in the middle of your cake platform. Now what you can do is add some icing. You're going to want to have a fair amount of icing in between your cakes. So go ahead and scoop out a big healthy plop and drop it right there in the middle. Now, using a rubber spatula, spread that around the middle of your cake. Never forget, folks, you can always add more icing if you don't think there's enough. Once you think you've got enough of your frosting in the middle of your cake, you can add your top cake and start icing around the sides. Behold, the worst decorated carrot cake you've ever seen in your life. Well, I'm not going to win any awards for my cake decorating skills, but I just might for the flavor. Let's grab ourselves a bite. That concludes this week's Easter episode of Cooking Corner with Giuseppe CrimiVaroli. Next time, I'll take a cake decorating course. If you like this video, leave a like below. If there's something you'd like to see on the channel, leave it in the comments and I'll try to make it for you. Just please, no more cakes. And if you like videos like this, subscribe to the channel. I'm putting out new content all the time. Happy Easter and bye-bye now.